stop here. 28.
Favor, Mr. Marsh. It may not have been easy, but I got the message loud and clear. Go back to where you came from, Miss Peggy Sawyer. And that's just what I'm going to do.
I'm here to apologize for what happened and to ask you to come back.
I have a train to catch, Mr. Marsh.
And take over Dorothy Brock's role in Pretty Lady. Her ankle's broken. She's out of the show. But if you can pull it off, the role is yours.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. Show business isn't for me. I'm going back to Allentown.
What was that word you just said? Allentown? I give you a chance to star in the biggest musical this town's seen in 20 years, and you say Allentown. Now listen, Sawyer, and listen good. If you don't give a damn about me, think of the kids that you'll be throwing out of work if you don't do this. Think of the songs that will wither and die if you don't get up there and sing them. Think of the scenery that will never be seen, the costumes never worn, the orchestrations never heard. Think of Pretty Lady and the thrill and pleasure it could give to millions. Think of musical comedy, the two most glorious words in the English language. Sawyer, think of Broadway, damn it!
Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway, the hip hooray and ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway, the rumble of a subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain at Angelo's and Maxie's. When a Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning. The Broadway babies don't sleep tight until the dawn.
Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway.
Sleep.
the taxis.
The daffodils who entertain until the dawn.
Bye.